Hi, it's David Yeagley, once again, speaking to Comanche people as the fifth generation direct descendant of Gunne Kishsuit, Bad Eagle. I want to talk about Comanche sovereignty and Comanche money and just how it works at present. I asked my elderly mother once, just a few years before she died, and I said, "Mom, what is sovereignty? What is sovereignty?" She said, "Well, it's doing what you want to do. Doing what you're free to do, or being free to do what you want to do." She said it in one sentence, being able to do what you want to do. And actually she said, doing what you want to do. Well, I don't know if there is such a thing as pure sovereignty. If there is, I don't know who has it, because we all have our limitations, you know. But in terms of how money is spent, our tribe, and it's true for other tribes also, have a way of spending money that is a little peculiar, I think. For instance, one of our programs, which I mentioned before, Comanche Economic Development. This is one of our programs that it gets close to 2 million, under 2 million. It's over a million a year, I believe. Basically, the way the tribe is set up, the leaders divide the money amongst programs, and that's where the bulk of it goes. Tribal programs that involve, or at least theoretically involve, all the members of the tribe. But we know that doesn't really happen. What happens is a lot of the money, most of the money, goes into the hands of a few people. And these programs employ Comanche people. And most of these programs have rather fancy salaries, large salaries, 200,000, 150, 200. I've heard terrible things on the size of the salaries of some of these administrators for these programs. In this particular program, economic development, it's about creating jobs. It's similar in concept to that Comanche Enterprises. Their concept was to buy existing businesses and own them and employ Comanche people. Economic development is more about creating jobs. I think that's the distinction. In any case, this program boasts of various companies. Economic development has an 80% Comanche employment rate. Total jobs, 150, full-time 50, part-time 100, and it names a few of the companies, the seven businesses that they're managing. It's basically it's basically blue collar, but there are some, there's Comanche Nation Funeral Home, for instance. That's business. And I don't know if they have their, if we have Comanche morticians, I'll have to look into that a little bit deeper. My point is, our nation is trying to create jobs for our people so that our nation's money is paid to our own people. That concept, I think, is less than healthy because it's very limited. It's the number of people, 150. There's maybe 1,400 Comanches within the general area of Southwest Oklahoma. I'm not sure about that. The issue would be, what about all the other people that don't have a Comanche job? A Comanche job is a high status item. It's a wonderful thing, to be a Comanche employed by the Comanche Nation. How exalted, and it is among Comanche people. That's tops. But not everybody can have it. There's not enough money to pay every Comanche a salary, and there's not enough administrative jobs or Comanche college jobs to pay everybody, every employee $100,000 a year. In other words, it's very, very inequitable the way in which our tribe divides the money. Now, it's true that some of these tribal programs, such as the funeral home, we have a transportation service for our elders, for our elderly. We have a programs for the elderly. Those do need to be administered, and there does need to be a full-time job. These things need to exist to an extent, but creating a job for a young Comanche person in an economic development program, for instance, there's a cleaning service, there's a waterworks, summertime amusement park, water park that we have. That it may employ, a few Comanches, but I'm saying that that's not the same thing as a job out in the world. You're still on the umbilical cord. You're still connected to money that comes to you as a result of your being Comanche. Hopefully, that's the way it works. That's not quite where we want to be, I don't believe. And what we have is a system where a few people get a lot of money and most of the people get very little, such as that per capita payment, which was a little over $1,000 a year. See, I'm thinking that there are some of these major programs that might be, the money might be redistributed more evenly among the people. Whenever you say something like, I want to help the people, and I've even said this already, I'd like to see more money in the pockets, in the cash, more cash in the hands of all the people, instead of large amounts among a few Comanches, a few elite people. But when you say something like that, it's threatening to those that have these positions. And they don't want to hear that, and they and all of their family members will be offended by that. I realize that. So this is an issue, and I'm just thinking objectively, maybe there are some programs that don't really need to exist, and that money could be spread out more evenly among all the people. Our tribe has never worked that way. That concept has never operated in our tribe. The way our constitution is set up, the way our government is set up, and the way it has been handled, our tribe has never worked that way. We'll talk more about this later.